Singapore hangs a man for trafficking drugs, the city state's second execution in 3 weeks. The man was convicted in 2019 of trafficking around 1.5 kilos of cannabis. A last-ditch appeal to review the case and say his execution was dismissed on Tuesday. Singapore has some of the world's toughest anti-narcotics laws. Trafficking more than 500 grams of cannabis can result in the death penalty. Despite growing international calls to abolish the death penalty, Singapore insists that it is an effective deterrent against trafficking. 13 death row inmates have been hanged since Singapore resumed executions in March 2022, after a hiatus of more than 2 years. Moscow denies Kyiv's claim that Ukraine neutralized a weapon that Moscow said was all but unstoppable. Ukraine said it intercepted 6 Russian Kinzhal missiles during an intense Russian air attack early Tuesday and shot down all missiles aimed at the capital. But Russia's defense minister dismissed the report and asserted a missile had actually destroyed a U.S.-built Patriot air defense system. Russian President Vladimir Putin has repeatedly touted the Kinzhal as a next-generation hypersonic missile that can defy most air defense systems because of their speed. Brazil's former president Jair Bolsonaro answers questions from police as part of a probe into his allegedly falsified COVID-19 vaccination records. In his 3-hour testimony, Bolsonaro asserted he had never been vaccinated and he had never presented any documentation indicating that he was. During the pandemic, the ex-president staunchly criticized the efficacy of the COVID-19 vaccine. Federal police claimed they uncovered a scheme in which one of Bolsonaro's aides obtained fraudulent vaccination certificates for Bolsonaro, his family, and select members of his cabinet. Authorities believe the fake records were made so Bolsonaro and his anti-vaccine inner circle could dodge travel requirements and restrictions. Kenyan authorities discovered 10 more bodies amid their ongoing probe into a doomsday cult. This brings the number of victims to more than 200. 3 men in critical condition were also found and taken to a nearby hospital. Pastor Paul McKenzie allegedly told his followers they would go to heaven if they starved themselves. The pastor is currently in police custody, and authorities claim they've arrested 4 more people with links to the cult. The search is still ongoing for hundreds more who have been reported missing. New Zealand police now treating a deadly hostel fire in the capital, Wellington, as arson after initially expressing belief that it was not deliberate. A homicide inquiry has been opened. The blaze broke out in the early hours of Tuesday, killing at least 6 people and causing major structural damage that's hampering recovery efforts. 11 people remain unaccounted for. Police also revealed there was a separate couch fire 2 hours earlier inside the building, which went unreported. The hostel provided accommodation for construction workers, hospital staff, and those serving sentences in the community for minor crimes, among others. The Western Canadian city of Calgary placed under a special weather alert Tuesday. This is as dry weather and shifting winds elevated the risk of spreading wildfires in the region. Residents are also warned of poor air quality and reduced visibility. In the oil-producing province of Alberta, where Calgary is located, some 90 wildfires are active, 23 of which are out of control. The blazes have scorched about 600,000 hectares, forcing 20,000 people out of their homes. Military and firefighters from Canada and the U.S. have already teamed up to contain the fires.